Hello traders. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening to you all. For those of you who are new to us, we are the TSTWS1S08 traders, and our website is www.stochastic-macd.com. For all trade, we'll use the 5% money management rules and apply stop loss in all trade. This video is for educational purposes only. It's neither a solicitation nor an offer to buy or sell any financial instrument. And it is primarily for the TSTWS1S08 traders. Okay? Now, today is 13th of January 2012, and before New York was open, I was posting a video today, okay, regarding the London session. Okay, yesterday I did post a video regarding the New York session, okay, New York trading session. Okay, so if you have not watched the video that we titled New York session or the London session, you must as well go and watch these two videos regarding the New York session and the London session, how you can, okay, prepare yourself, okay, and set a plan, okay, before you start your trading. Okay, this is the continuation of the video regarding the day trading. Okay, and the title of this video is pure day trading strategy. Pure day trading strategy. Okay, now, as a day trader, you do not have the whole day, okay, to plan your strategy or to wait for the price, okay, to move up and down. You want to make sure that you are coming into the market at the right time, at the right place, which means, okay, you want to sell, you want to sell at a valid resistance level and also at the right time. Okay, if you remain in a day trade for more than 2 hours and it didn't work out, you know that, okay, the price telling you that, okay, to pack it up, okay, and go and come back another day. Okay, this is just so important. Okay, now a lot of new traders, okay, love day trading. Okay, but day trading is a serious matter because you are competing with the best traders, okay, the market makers, you are competing with the market specialists, you are competing with the experienced traders, okay, and you are betting against the market itself, which means you are trying to, okay, make a decision, okay, a quick and accurate decision. Okay, and it requires a lot of experience, a lot of knowledge, and a lot of practice. Very important practice. And as I say to traders, it's always practice, okay? Everything you want to do in this life, if you practice, 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 okay, you can surprise yourself, okay? Practice, 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 and you will build what I call the pattern, the mental pattern, okay? The mental pattern, okay? What you go through every day, paying attention to the news also is very important. Now, enough of my blah, blah, blah. The first thing that we want to talk about, if we are talking about pure day trading, we must draw the line for the market opening time. Right here today, we see New York was opening right here at 2:30 p.m. London time. That's, okay, 9:30 a.m. Eastern time. Right here, that's the yellow line telling us that this is the time the market is open. The next line that you will draw is the closing time of New York, exactly here at 9 p.m. London time. Okay, that's 4 p.m. Eastern time. You draw the opening time and quickly draw the end, the closing time straight away. The next thing that you want to draw during the New York session, as you see today, okay, is +2. New York is open here. You do +2 hours, which is the white horizontal line here, bringing you to the 4:30 p.m. London time. Okay, 2 hours plus. Okay, that's 11:30 Eastern time. And then also you draw the London closing time at 5 p.m. London time. That's 12 p.m. Eastern time. And also you draw another line, which is the green one here. This is, okay, 7:30 p.m. London time. Okay, that's 2:30 p.m. Eastern time. And the gap period is between, okay, 11:30, okay, a.m. Eastern time out to 2:30 p.m. Eastern time. That's where I put the spotlight here. Okay, so you want to know where is the gap period. Okay, those who are trading the TSCW24 understand what I'm talking about here, the gap period. I told them all the time, watch the gap period, watch the gap period. Okay, so New York was opening today here. The strategy, you draw all your lines. Okay, you draw all your lines. Do not be afraid to draw your lines. just draw them. So I was telling you this to them, that as far as we remain below this trend line, okay, we must give priority to bearish signal. Let's see whether you have made a right decision or not, okay? So market was open here. The price was approaching this support level, which I put the yellow line here. We need to be very careful, and it dip below it fast. Down, the market want to retest this level and quickly return up. And one thing the importance about, so talking about pure day trading strategy, is to drill your day, and map your time carefully. This is about mapping your time carefully. So you have done your preparation, you set your map, the market is now open, you draw your line, the trend line, the channel, the resistance, and the support level. This is the line we are watching, okay? The support level here. We went below it, okay? What do we wait for? If the price dip below it, you want to wait for it to retest it. It retest it here, in fact, close above it. Ouch, close above it, okay? Now you know that it's not a good one, okay? It's not going to go down very much because it dip below it, but instead of retesting on the dot and turn around, it closes it below, above it, right here. So you know that it's not going to be good. Another thing you need to pay attention to, today is Friday. Friday, what usually take place? Professional, okay, are adjusting their portfolio because they don't want to, okay, expose their portfolio for, okay, the unpredictable weekend, so to speak, okay. They don't know what is going to be happening during the weekend, whether, okay, there will be another downgrade of another country, any crazy news will come out, any natural catastrophe will happen that will create, okay, price gapping down or gapping up on Monday morning, and all the blah blah blah. So on Friday, professional adjusting their portfolio, big investor will have adjusted their portfolio, they will take profit, they will close some trade that they are not supposed to close, just in case, okay, the swing traders will take profit, they will reduce their loss, they will move their stop loss, so you will see, the price will do all sorts of things as New York is open. So you see that today, you can expect very often, Friday is usually a choppy market, okay? And right here on this chart, as I told you, the price does not always trend. So what do we have today? We have what we call a consolidation session. You see, during the New York session, this is the time that a lot of day traders will lose money because they do not know that the price is not going to trend, because, like I told you before, this is the price will go, talking about the market pattern, trend, pulse, trend. So we have a trend down. Okay, now we have a consolidation. Monday we will watch this. Okay, one must watch when the market will open next time. One must watch this consolidation session because there was a trend. Okay, but we are expecting the euro, okay, to continue the movement to the downside slowly and gradually. It become a bit tricky now to enter the trade because it's just rolling it down, rolling it down, rolling it down. Because if you want to sell, you want to see a rally, okay, to the upside. So talking about pure day trading strategy, you want to map your time. Talking about the last indicator, very important. A lot of traders forget about that. So the gap period, we know that a lot of fake signal will take place. And know where a market is opening and when a market is about to close. The first hours is the brokest time. The last hour also is the brokest time. Okay, understanding the psychology of market participants and what is taking place. Talking about Friday, the strategy is to know that professional will adjust their portfolio. So sometimes, because instead of the price going up, they may sell because they don't want the trade to remain open, so they will close it, okay? So while this adjustment is taking place, okay, and a lot of traders get into trouble on Friday, and sometimes traders that are making money during the week time will give everything back on Friday, okay? So now you understand why sometimes the market is funny on Friday, and most professional, okay, they will trade only probably, okay, the first hour of New York and then just go home, okay? So now you know it. Also, talking about Friday, okay, sometime when the market is about to close on Friday, you see all kind of beautiful pattern and people will enter the trade. So they will see like, oh, this is a double bottom pattern. They will place a trade already waiting for Monday. Monday comes, the forex market will open, or the stock market will open, and they probably will do the opposite, completely the opposite. Because of this adjustment, a lot of indicator will be distorted, okay, because stock that are not supposed to be sold are sold, okay. Stock that are not supposed to be, okay, bought are bought, and because of the portfolio adjustment. Okay, so people are selling, people are buying. It's just because they want to take profit, they want to protect some portfolio, they don't want to expose too much risk. They are managing their portfolio, talking about risk, and it creates a lot of distortion in the market. So you see your indicator showing maybe a buy signal, but it's a fake signal, or you may say it give you a sell signal on Friday evening, and you see, oh, this is what we have been talking about before, and Monday something else will completely happen because of the adjustment. Come Monday again, okay, some stock will gap out, some stock will gap down, talking about forex and all the rest of it. And again, Monday, begin, New York is open, okay, if the stock gap up and some people make a huge profit by chance, stock gap up, and they get it right, they will take profit in the market, okay. The first 2 hours, again, is a messy, okay, for Monday also. So talking about Friday, okay, and also Monday, you have to understand that there is a lot of portfolio adjustment on Friday and also on Monday, okay? That's why some professionals do not trade even on Monday. They trade on from Tuesday, okay, to Thursday, okay? Now you're understanding. On Wednesday, talking about day trading, we are expecting the oil inventory that will attract a lot of speculators in the market, and they usually come already, okay, on Tuesday evening, placing their trade. These are gamblers, these are speculators, these are also market participants, and they will create all sort of market, okay, distortion also. So be aware of it, especially if you are swing trading. Watch out for Wednesday, very important. If you are swing trader, watch out for Wednesday because of all sort of market speculators coming to the market on Wednesday because of the oil inventory, usually on Wednesdays, okay. Sometimes they will move it to Thursday, but very often on Wednesday. So talking about day trading, you map it, okay? So you draw your line, the key level. So today you can see, I told you, if you remain this, give priority to sell signal. So the best place to sell is when the price was touching this level here. New York, you can see New York was close here, but because forex market is closing at 10 p.m. London time, that's why we came to this level here, but New York was closed right here, okay? Okay, so you map it, you draw it in. So this will be a better place for a day trader to look for opportunity to sell as the price retested this declining trend line. But you can see there was a consolidation in this session. So the market pattern is consolidation on this time frame, this 30-minute chart of the Euro USD. Okay? This strategy is applicable to stock, to all the financial instruments that you can trade. Okay? So these are just a few things talking about market protocols, the thing that as a day trader you need to be aware of, okay, the clock, and mapping your day carefully and watch out carefully and know, okay, the reaction on the price, what sort of activity is taking place in the market at that point in time. One thing also you need to remember, as soon as New York is open, especially for forex traders, you must watch Google and Apple. These are market leaders, and they are controlling the market during that time. During the London session, you must watch also the London leaders, okay? This is just very important, okay, information for day traders. As always, one must continue to practice, okay? Practice and practice and practice, okay? Thank you for watching, okay? And we will speak to you very soon. Until the next time, enjoy yourself and be very happy.